Hey guys, Hobbs here, bringing you another tutorial. This time is going to be on mech maneuvers and mech movement. Essentially, yes, I'm going to be teaching you how to walk in this tutorial. Now, you might be wondering, why Hobbs, why are you telling us how to walk? Well, simple. Hawken is a game where mobility is king, and if, you know, your mobility isn't as optimized as it should be, you're going to suffer a little bit. And, like as I said before, a lot of times, new players, the biggest problem that they have is that they don't move correctly, as you know, a lot of the better players do. The best pilots, they know how to move smoothly. They know all sorts of little tricks and maneuvers, like even the basic ones and advanced ones, but the thing about it is they know how to pull them off smoothly and with some control. Those are the two keywords right there. Smoothness equals speed and control. This is what I'm going to help teach you guys. I'm going to go launch into the training mode right here so I can show you guys a little bit, you know, better on you know, inside of a much more controlled environment. And I also you know, these moves should work with any mech, but they will differ depending on the results of the mech and how that mech itself moves, but it should work with any mech. And I also personally rebound my keys. The only things that I changed was I moved the dodge button to space and the hover button to shift. But other than that, let's get into it. I'm going to show you guys some simple maneuvers. Okay, just one last thing before we jump right into the mech maneuvers. This video is going to be split up into two parts. In this first part, I'm mostly going to be covering just how you would actually pull off the move, and then why you would want to use it in a certain situation, and also its usage just alone. The second part, we'll be talking a bit more like on that concept I talked about, which is smoothness and piloting and stringing all the forms together. So it'll be a bit more the big picture statement, and it'll obviously take a lot more explaining because each of these things on their own is intricate in their own nature, and I'll explain that on this video. And then the second video will be going into a bit more advanced concepts, you know, not just talking about how to do certain stuff and why, but how you would use them all together in like the bigger scope of things. But, you know, with that said, let's just get on and then let me show you how to actually pull this stuff off. Let's just start with the basics. Okay, so this first section, I'm going to be talking about very simple mech maneuvers. In fact, a lot of these maneuvers are probably pretty default. You may already know them, but I still want to go over them to make sure that you guys got it in your heads, because believe me, some people, they usually forget these basics, and of course, I just want to have these basics fresh in your mind. But these are very simple mech maneuvers that usually don't require too much or very complicated input from either the keyboard or the mouse. So again, these are very simple maneuvers, anybody should be able to do them, and as I list them off, you'll probably agree, you should be able to do this on your own. Okay, so this first one right here is pretty dang obvious. It's the circle strafe. It seems pretty obvious, but it's a very important skill to have. You have to be able to walk around somebody and keep your aim steady on them inside of any first-person shooter game. Pretty much, it's just simple. All you gotta do is just walk to the sideways and then turn your mouse to keep your reticule right on the person. And of course, it's almost like a default. If you don't know this, you're gonna have a hard time trying to play any kind of first-person shooter game. But, you know, other than that, I really don't need to explain it too much. It's pretty much just being able to walk in a circle around your enemy and able to keep your reticule on them. Okay, so moving on. Okay, so the next move that I'm going to be going over is the hover. And I know, it's a very standard move and everyone should know it, but a lot of people misuse it. They tend to hover until they run out of fuel, which is a very bad thing because you're out of fuel, you have no mobility. And if you're out of mobility in this game, well, you're kind of dead because, as I said, in Hawken, mobility is very, very important. If you're going to use a hover, use it like you would a jump or a hop. You go up for about like maybe a second or two and then you come back down. You do not want to hover until your fuel runs out. And plus, it'll just make you a very easy target because usually once you're hovering and then you max out your altitude, you're going to be moving fairly slowly. And again, slow is a bad thing inside a mobility-based game. So your best bet is to try and stay on the ground when you can. Hover when you need to. But again, try to use it sparingly. That's also why I encourage you to switch out the dodge and the hover keys from space to put the dodge on the space because, you know, spacebar is easier to press and you should be dodging and boosting more than you should be hovering. So again, that's why I made that switch. But again, moving on to the next move. And of course, the next move I'm going to be showing off now is the dodge. If you don't know how to dodge, duck, dip, dive, and dodge. If you don't know the 5 Ds of dodgeball, you're going to have a hard time in this game. And again, very obvious, but you would not believe how many new guys I see not dodging. And now I understand it's kind of intimidating at first because people would think their aim would get affected. Well, of course, yeah. I mean, if you're juking side to side, it will affect your aim. But again, it's just part of the learning experience. And trust me, you're going to want to really learn how to dodge and being able to fight your opponents. Because half of the skill is learning how to dodge and also keep your aim consistent on your enemies. it's also part of the fun on it. I mean, how many other games do you get to, you know, dodge rockets and stuff like that? Not very many let you actively do that on a regular basis. But yes, the dodge is definitely something you're going to need to master because it is used in a lot, well, practically all of the mech maneuvers I'm going to be talking about, and of course, pro players use it all the time. Although I will tell you something on the dodge really quick. Some people have a tendency to try and spam the dodge, as in like they dodge exactly with the cooldowns. After a while, that will become very predictable, and more experienced players will easily recognize that, and they will be able to take you out despite the fact that you're dodging everywhere at the time. You want to try and remain unpredictable with your dodges, but again, I'll probably talk about this at a later time in the video after we've gone over the basics. Also, one last thing on the subject of dodging before we move on to the next maneuver. The dodge is better to use for defensive and evasive moves. I wouldn't use it aggressively too much, because usually if you use it aggressively too much, it'll usually leave you a little bit more open than you would like. So be careful when using a dodge aggressively, because you know you have to wait like a second and a half in order to reuse another dodge. The main thing you want to use the dodge for is for dodging rockets and explosives headed your way. Don't try to dodge bullets and machine gun fire, because that's not the best way to utilize it. Use it to dodge tow rockets, grenades, and maybe the occasional sable rifle from the sniper that's in the far off. But you can even use it to avoid hellfires by dodging behind cover. That's how the dodge should be best utilized. But again, now moving on to the next maneuver. To continue in the line of really basic maneuvers that you should already know is the boost. Yes, you gotta know how to utilize the boost, how to use it correctly, when to use it, because I know people are used to a lot of games where you sprint everywhere to try and get somewhere fast. Well, that's good, except, well, boosting, it'll give you away on the radar, and so to keep stealth, you don't always want to use it, especially when you can tell that there's enemies nearby or if you don't know where the enemies are. But again, I'll go over stealth and situational awareness on a separate video. However, you do want to make sure that you want to be able to boost more instead of fly, because, well, flying is a lot slower than boosting forward, and boosting forward will keep your mobility up and make you much harder to hit than if you were trying to fly. You want to save most of your fuel for your boosting, not for flying, because, as I said, in this game you want to boost and dodge a lot more than you do with flying, and so that's why I recommended that rebinding your keys to that. So again, boost is very important, and we'll go over a bit more on its usage when I get into more of the advanced maneuvers. Just remember to keep this in mind. Although, the last thing I'll leave you with on the boost is that it's generally used for much more aggressive moves. Once you know where your target is, or you've already engaged boosting around and trying to use it to get close to an enemy is definitely a good idea. And, you know, but yeah, it's definitely the better. It's used in a lot more of the more aggressive maneuvers that I'll be teaching. Again, just keep this in mind. Dodging is a bit more for defensive, while the boost is a bit more for aggressive maneuvers. However, just remember, after you boost, your weapons will be down for about a half of a second before they get raised up again. So that's something you'll have to keep in mind when you go boosting forward, when you're engaging an enemy. You'll have to remember that delay when you boost. But again, moving on to the next maneuver. Now, the last basic maneuver I'm going to be talking about is the 180 spin. You can do that by hitting the dodge modifier and then hitting back, and then hitting S. I know it's good for turning around very quickly, however, it's a little bit clunky because your mech is forced to stop whenever you do the 180 spin. I mean, it can be used in some situations, but in a lot of situations, like where I said, their smoothness is the key. A lot of the times this 180 spin will affect that smoothness, so it's not always the best option to use. There's an option that I can teach you that's probably a little bit better, but you know, in a really, if you're caught in a pinch and you're getting surprised from behind, it's probably good to do a 180 spin. But again, try not to overuse this move, because again, it'll leave you wide open. In fact, you want to avoid trying to hit this weapon, the button combination for that by mistake, because again, it does freeze you in place, and if you're in the middle of a dodge or boosting away, it can end up with disastrous results. So yeah, just be aware that it's there, but try not to use it too much. Okay, now this next section is going to be the more advanced maneuvers, and when I say more advanced, I mean there's going to be a lot more fancy finger work and, you know, keyboard work, mouse work that's going to be involved. It's going to be, it's going to be kind of confusing, and I'll have to take time to try and explain, and I might even just show on screen, like, the button combinations and what I'm doing in order to pull these crazy moves off that you probably see me do a lot in my videos, and you aren't sure, like, how the hell is that guy moving around so fast? Well, here, this, I'm going to show you guys a lot of these fancy handwork that I do and to try and move around fast, and a lot of the mech maneuvers, and I'll give you a couple good examples of them, and also, after the video, if there's anything that I missed or that you'd like to explain, you can also have explained there. But for the list that I came up with for the purposes of this video, well, you know, here we go. All right, the first advanced maneuver that I'm going to teach you, well, it's not that advanced and it's not that hard to pull off, but it's just something that most people really are not aware of. It's called the angle boost. All it really is you just boost forward by hitting, you know, space W, like when my keybinds, you go space W, and then it, depending on whether you want to go right or left, you hit A or D at the same time, and you will actually do a diagonal boost in the direction that you choose. Now, it is very useful because, again, I use this definitely to form more, much more aggressive engagements, because I can boost forward, but also to the side, so I'm not boosting directly forward at my enemy where they have an easy shot at me. I'm still moving sideways to help keep the aim a little bit hard for them to keep up with me. And plus, it is also very great for approaching corners, because you're already sort of facing around the corner rather than, you know, facing at 90 degrees from the corner and you have to turn. And you have to turn in order to face the proper way. You're already facing, you're facing the right way almost, and you have to turn much less, and you're much more prepared for what's going to happen when you round that corner. So, yeah, and like I said, it's very good to advance on people, like when, even in a close quarters fight. I mean, you still have to be aware that doing this boost will cause you to lower your weapons, and you'll have to wait like a half second for them to raise again, and there's a couple maneuvers that I can teach you that'll help counter that. But again, remember this angle boost, because this angle boost comes in handy a lot when it comes to a lot of the other more advanced maneuvers. Just remember the angle boost right here. In fact, you know, yeah, if anything that you should take away from this is the angle boost is something that you should definitely be aware of. Okay, the next move is going to be the boost hop. Now, it's not very hard to pull off, although the reasons why you want to do it is a lot more complicated. So I'll just tell you how you do it. As you're boosting forward, all you really have to do is just tap, is just hit your hover key and hop up for about, like, you know, a second or two. And what it's used for is, like I said, it's a bit more complicated. The maneuver itself is pretty simple to pull off. But try to bear with me while I explain it here. As you boost forward, when you end your boost, like I said, you have that half a second where you have to raise your weapons, like when you come out of any sprint. But, you know, if in any, like, any sprint in a game like Halo, if you jump at the end of your sprint, you keep that forward momentum that you would have had while you were... You keep that forward momentum you had while sprinting, and you don't slow down. Whereas if you had slowed down on the ground, you would have... If you stopped the sprint on the ground, you would have lost some of your momentum and you would have slowed down a bit. And so that's essentially what the boost hop does. It lets you keep some of that speed that you have while you're going through the air. And so while you're raising your weapon, you're a little bit harder to hit than you normally would have been. And it'll make it, you know, it'll just help your piloting feel a lot more smooth. It doesn't actually raise your weapons any faster. It just helps you keep your momentum and your speed up. That's the whole point of the boost hop, is just keeping with smoothness and keeping your momentum moving. Especially when you're trying to round a corner with a boost. It definitely helps. There's also another move, but that'll be the next one. But boost hops are definitely something that you can use to your advantage to make sure you maintain your momentum at the end of a jump, at the end of a boost, sorry. And yeah, keep moving forward and make sure your mobility and your ability stays high. You can use it with any class. I even do it in my C classes. Even if you're mech is horrible in the air, you're just hopping up for a quick second, like a half of a second, and it's just to maintain momentum. But other than that, you know, that's all it's really used for. You generally don't want to fly after you come out of a boost, because that just uses a stupid amount of fuel. But again, I think I'm getting sidetracked here, so moving on to the next maneuver. Okay, so this next move right here is called the L dodge, and it's a bit more of an offensive maneuver, but it's not too complicated to try and pull off. I just say it's a bit more of an advanced maneuver because it requires a bit more timing and a bit more practice to pull off. Pretty much all you really do is you boost forward and then you suddenly change direction by either hitting the dodging to the left or dodging to the right. And essentially what this move does is that it'll help to mess up an opponent's aim. They'll see you dashing forward, they'll probably line up their shot to, you know, compensate for that, but then you suddenly change direction and it turns out they end up missing their shot or their tow rocket. And it does a great job of trying to outmaneuver an enemy like that and confuse them as to where exactly your whereabouts are. And also it's great because when you boost forward and then when you end your boost, you know that you tend to lose your momentum a little bit, and you also have your weapons lowered for a small period of time, just like when you sprint in any other game. The dodge helps offset that and keeps you moving and moving quickly, because it leaves you very less vulnerable because of because you're moving much faster and because you're moving much faster and you're hard to hit while your weapons are down. So it'll help give you that bit of an edge. So, and then of course, usually by the time your dodge is done, your weapons will already be up. In fact, usually mid-dodge, my weapons are usually up and ready to go. And the only other thing I can say is that, you know, being able to keep track of your target while you're doing the L-dodge, as you dodge to the side, just having to keep your aim steady on your target, that takes a bit of practice, but, you know, it's a very good maneuver to use. It's pretty solid, pretty simple, and it works quite well on a lot of newer players. Although, more experienced players, they might see that you start to do this move and start to pick up on it. Okay, this next move is called the Wave Dash, and it is actually really complicated to try and explain and also tell you how to pull it off, because there's a lot of things that, such as timing, and it's a lot of fancy finger work here. But this is like the basis for a lot of the more advanced mech maneuvers, so you really need to pay attention here on how to learn how to wave dash. And there's going to be a lot of there's going to be a lot of stuff I'm explaining here, so try to pay attention. But how you pull off the wave dash, well, I'm going to have to slow down that footage I have of one of the wave dashes right here, so I can actually give you a much more accurate representation of how to actually do it, because it involves pushing a lot of keys and having to do a lot of mouse input in very rapid succession. So again, that's why I'm going to slow it down and show it to you guys. So let's go through this. Okay, so to start off a wave dash, I usually go with an angle boost. I have to first determine which way I'm going to be going, and whichever way I push the angle boost into, I have to turn the camera in the opposite direction. Now, you angle boost at about a 45 degree angle, and once you turn your camera to the opposite direction about 45 degrees, you hit the dodge button right here, and then that makes your mech dodge into the direction of your initial angle boost. So essentially what this move accomplishes is that it allows you to dodge into a boost, essentially is what you're doing. So that's what involves turning the camera. Now again, how I can best explain it, whichever direction you are going to turn the camera, like say you're going to turn the camera to the right when you do it, make sure you angle boost to the left and dodge to the left. And you know, same thing, or vice versa. You're gonna turn the camera left. You're gonna turn the camera left. You angle boost to the right and dodge to the right. That way, you go into the direction of your boost. Now, if you don't do an angle boost and you do it off of a straight boost, it's a little bit tougher. You gotta wait a little bit longer before you hit the dodge button to perform the actual wave dash, but it's just the same exact thing. I usually do the angle boost, that way I don't have to turn so much and I keep a little bit more control over the wave dash, because sometimes, you know, I've done a couple wave dashes where I was slightly off and then it ended up being a little bit funky. But yeah, this move, as I said, it's really complicated, and like I said, it's really hard to explain. Hopefully by, you know, like watching that video and that slow-mo of what I was doing, maybe you can get a better idea. But what this is used for is definitely, it's used for all kinds of stuff. I use it all the time, usually to approach an enemy or maybe round a corner, because then it'll keep my momentum going, and by the time the dodge is done, usually I'll have my weapons back up. So it's really great to round a corner and just immediately start firing if you know someone is right around a corner. And it's great for pulling off a little trick like that. Also, as you can clearly see me dancing around the hologram with all these wave dashes, it's really great for just, you know, just flat out maneuvering somebody. If you know how to wave dash, I mean, it makes it pretty tough for you. It makes you pretty tough to hit, I mean, because people really aren't used to seeing a mech that's moving around really, really fast. In fact, I use it all the time, you know, quickly dash for cover. I'll usually just, like, boost forward, and when I'm about to get to the cover, I'll just do the dodge right into the, right behind the wall. So yeah, it's really great to get between, to cross spaces, like short spaces, and you know, just really, really fast. It's meant to just be a really fast move and meant to make you just super hard to hit. Even in heavy mechs, I mean, it'll make my brawler seem like it's moving faster than it should, and people get often confused. But yeah, that's the secret, is this the wave dash thing. Oh yeah, one last thing about the wave dash is that you can actually do an aerial version of the wave dash by boost hopping just before you hit the dodge button while you're turning the camera. So just, and you have to have the air compressor in order to do this, but if you hop up just before you hit the dodge button to do the wave dash, you'll do an aerial wave dash. It can be useful in some situations, but it just, and honestly, it just uses extra fuel, so I'd avoid doing that. but it does come in handy for another move that we're going to talk about in a bit. Okay, this next move right here, I call the 180 dash, and essentially all it really is it's just a modified wave dash, but instead of maybe turning your camera back forward after performing the dash, or just leaving your camera where it is, and just like, you know, only turning 90 degrees, what you do is you turn it 180 degrees as you perform the dodge. Like, in the actual dodge itself, you actually could turn the camera another full 90 degrees, so you're basically facing completely the other way around from where you initially started off. It's also a really great move to try and pull off for flying enemies who love to fly over your head. All you gotta do is just do the wave dash under them with the 180, you know, while turning all the way around and point the camera a little bit up. You'll be right under them in their blind spot, and they'll have a hard time trying to find where you are, and you're already ready to shoot them. But yeah, as I said, while trying to pull off this 180 dash, it's a little bit tough at first, but once you get the wave dash down, it's just turning the camera all the way around, essentially. And that's all it really comes, like, in the hardest part. And I know there are turning caps in place, but you can do this. I can even do this move in my heavy mix. So, I mean, you might need a little bit of dash space, and actually, I don't have a very high sensitivity. For those who think that I have a really high sensitivity, that's why I'm able to pull this move off. No, my sensitivity is actually just the default sensitivity. But, yeah, this move is really great. It really confuses enemies, and it keeps you completely mobile. You don't have to stop in place in order to do the 180 turn by hitting, like, Shift S or something like that. And, yeah, it's a very mobile move. It moves you around really fast. It's great for dueling around enemies, suddenly charging forward and getting right in behind them and shooting them in their rear. You know, just keeping them guessing. They're not going to be able to find you. And, again, you know, all it really is just staying, like, super mobile. And, yeah, I mean, this is one of the best moves that you can definitely learn alongside the wave dash. In fact, the main reason why you want to learn the wave dash is so you can learn this move right here. I mean, don't use it, like, all the time, otherwise it'll become really predictable. Really predictable, but it is a really great move to use on people because most people, they have a hard time trying to counter this. Okay, so the last move I'm going to teach you here today is called the Leapfrog. Essentially, all it really is just an aerial wave dash. So, usually you start off by boosting forward, you hit your hover button soon after, and then just do the same as you would with a regular wave dash, just in the air. And yes, it requires you to have an air compressor in order to pull this move off, but it is very good for jumping over people's heads. But yeah, as I said, it's just a 180 dash in the air. So, how you go about using it, as I said, it's mainly to jump over people's heads. Usually you'd want a height advantage over the person before you try to jump over the head because, well, you know, not all mechs have very good aerial dynamics. I think the only mechs that would probably easily vault over people's heads are the Berserker, the Bruiser, and maybe the Rocketeer at times. But other than that, in most other mechs, you're probably going to want to actually have a little bit of a height advantage over somebody when you do this. You definitely do not want to be standing below them, otherwise, you know, it's going to be hard to get over the head. Because if you do the air dodge into their mech and you don't quite clear the top of their mech, they'll get stuck on the front end of their mech, more than likely because they're looking right at you, and then they can shoot you with relative ease. And you're going to be facing sideways at that point, so it's not a good position to be in. So don't pull off this move unless you know you can get over the person. It works great for heavy mechs that are sitting around in turret mode. You can just quickly vault right over them and shoot them in their delicate behind. And that is the Leapfrog. It is amazing, and once you learn how to get it down right, it is awesome and fun to use. The only downside is that it does burn up quite a bit of fuel because you're boosting forward, hovering, and then you're hitting your air compressor. It does use quite a bit of fuel to try and do it, so don't try to use this move too often. If you're going to do it once, get over the person, and then try to stay on the ground when you take out the person. I don't recommend trying to stay in the air too long after doing a move like this, because like I said, you need to try and conserve your fuel, and yeah, because your fuel is basically going to be save your life in this game. And that is pretty much the conclusion for this first part of my Mech Maneuvers guide. I hope you guys learned something. Hopefully you'll be able to dance circles around your enemies now that you know how to, now that you have some of these moves in your pocket. However, the second part, when I release it, will teach you how to further dance around people and annoy them to hell, like all those scouts that you see out there. I'll be able to teach you how to make your brawler move like an assault, kind of, sort of. I don't know. That might be promising a bit much, but I will teach you guys how to pilot more smoothly, more effectively, and be a lot harder to hit. So yeah, that's going to be coming up in part two. It's going to be a bigger picture of things, how you want to combine all these moves together, like how you would, how like, and I'll probably go over my own like train of thought as I'm, you know, piloting and stuff like that. So yeah, I guess I'll see you guys then for when I release the next video. I don't know exactly know when. I try to get one out every week, but I'm starting to get more and more busy, and next week I'm going to have school starting up, but I will try to get the second part out as soon as I can. So for now, this is Soldier Hobbs signing off, and I will see you for the next one.